the record that we have voting sheets. Senators Ball, Farley, Golden, McDonald, Seward, Adams, Krueger, Senator Montgomery, who is here, left a voting sheet, and Senator Cousins is here. And then we have Senators Larkin, Michelle Allen Young, Smith in the room. This, I don't know how many disclaimers one has to make, but this is being recorded, and so we'll just call it to order. The first bill is Senate 379, regard to a, Senator Rivera has just joined us. Senator Generis, who, I'm just trying to record, make record, who's here?
He keeps moving in and out.
Move the bill.
379 would simplify the process of recouping third-party payments for pharmaceuticals in regard to Medicaid dispensing.
Move the
discussion.
Second.
We have a move the bill. Senator Smith is second. The bill is reported to first reading. Second bill, 960102, in regard to opening up the process of waivers that the state must process in order to get changes in our Medicaid system. Right now, all changes in the Medicaid system have to be approved by the federal government. The state's Medicaid plan, which used to be something we had discretion with, needs approval. And if you want to go beyond what is current law and allowed for waivers, you have to apply for that. The difficulty is people do not know what is pending, and this would open up the process.
Move it.
Second.
Okay, it was moved and seconded. It's reported to first reading. This is posting of the same intent, posting of the plan on the internet website of the Health Department.
Move
Senate 961.
Second.
Senator McDonald. Moved and seconded. Senate 2387 relates to the possession of a defibrillator by an EMS practitioner. That right now you can operate it, but you can't possess it. And the idea is if an EMS practitioner is not necessarily on duty, but somebody who has been trained and there's a medical emergency, therefore we do this for life saving. Bill has been moved and seconded. Discussion. The last bill is 2556. In regard to requiring of Medicaid that there be coverage for hospital stays of at least 48 hours for a normal birth and 96 hours for a cesarean section birth. This policy is something we've required of private insurers probably over a decade ago, and it is actually a policy that Medicaid is following now. So that is what would be no cost implications. It will be, if approved by the committee, it will be reported to finance for a detailed financial statement.
Move it.
All right. Moved and seconded. The bill is reported to finance. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yep.